Welcome back to my channel, dear students. In this class, let us discuss about an important 5-mark derivation, that is derive an expression for electric potential energy of an electric dipole which is placed in an uniform electric field. So, as I said, it is an important 5-mark derivation. Okay. So, you might have seen how I have wrote the electric uniform electric field. So, on the board, while discussing about torque acting on an electric dipole, isn't it? So, that is a set of parallel lines represent uniform electric field at a place. Okay. So, this is the direction of uniform electric field, that is from left to right, that is along positive x-axis. It means that here is an imaginary positive plate and here is an imaginary negative plate. So electric field lines are starting from positive and ending at negative plate, isn't it? Okay, fine. Now let us consider an electric dipole here in the presence of uniform electric field. I will take like this. Let it be minus Q. Let it be plus Q. You know about an electric dipole? Two equal and opposite charges separated by a small distance is said to form an electric dipole. So like that, I have considered a pair of charges which are equal in magnitude but opposite in sign or nature. So let this be the center of the electric dipole and let it be the direction of electric dipole moment, which is always from negative charge to positive charge. Let this angle be some theta, that is angle made by the direction of electric dipole moment with the direction of electric field. Okay. Now, so usually electric potential energy of an isolated charge means what? It is the amount of work done in bringing that charge from infinity to any point in the external electric field. So will be stored in the form of electrical potential energy, isn't it? But when we come to the concept of two charges, there also we have discussed that. So the potential energy between the system of two charges is given by 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 divided by their separation distance, some smaller. Similarly for the system of three charges also we have discussed that in the last class. But now what may be the case in case of two equal and opposite charges, that is an electric dipole? Usually we say that electric potential energy of an electric dipole means it is the amount of work done in lifting, otherwise in rotating that electric dipole. So in the presence of an uniform electric field, so the amount of work done in deviating or in rotating an electric dipole, so through some angle, will be stored as electrical potential energy in this electric dipole. Okay. Now let us derive the expression for electric potential energy of an electric dipole which is placed in an uniform electric field. Okay. According to your previous knowledge, you can able to say under such condition, will this dipole experiences a force or not? It experiences two force because it consists of two charges. See, let me write like this. Since it is a positive charge, it will be attracted towards this negative plate in this direction with a force F is equal to Q times E. I am writing only the magnitude. Okay, here. This negative charge is attracted towards this positive plate with the same force F is equal to QE but in opposite direction. Due to these two equal and opposite forces acting on the same system simultaneously will always constitute a couple. Due to that couple, this electric dipole will experience a torque. That torque is given by, we know that the torque acting on this electric dipole is tau is equal to P E sin theta, isn't it? This is equation number 1. Now, what I will do? I will rotate the electric dipole through some small angle d theta. Therefore, the small work done, in rotating the dipole through a small angle d theta is given by dw is equal to tau into d theta. According to your system of particles and rotational motion chapter, so you might have heard this equation, W is equal to tau into theta. Okay, let me tell you how it comes. See, because we know that arc length S is equal to r theta. If you multiply this equation by F on both sides, if it becomes Fs is equal to Fr into theta. I am taking the maximum condition. The F into S, the maximum work done, is W. F into R, the maximum torque, tau into angular displacement theta. Next, for similarly, for small angles, dW is equal to tau into d theta. Like that, we extract the expression for work done in terms of torque and theta. Okay. The small work done in rotating the dipole through the small angle d theta is given by dW is equal to tau into d theta. Now, from equation number 1, we can put the formula for tau. It is given by P E sin theta d theta from equation 1. Isn't it? Okay. This is still the small amount of work done in rotating that electric dipole through small angle d theta. Okay. Similarly, the total work done, in rotating the dipole from angular position theta 1 to theta 2 is given by W is equal to integral theta 1 to theta 2 dW, isn't it? How to get W from dW means by just integrating it. Okay, the value of dW here, PE are constants, take them out, it becomes PE integral theta 1 to theta 2, remaining thing sin theta d theta. According to your integration concept, you might have heard about integration of sin theta with respect to theta, that is minus cos theta. PE into minus cos theta. I will write square bracket. Theta 2 upper limit, theta 1 is lower limit. I will take the negative sign out, outside. It becomes PE cos theta, theta 2, theta 1. Next, you know the procedure. First, we have to substitute the upper limit and then the lower limit. Therefore, it is minus PE into cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. On rearranging the terms, we get PE into cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. This is the expression for total work done in rotating the electric dipole from angular position theta 1 to theta 2. Now, according to the formality, we say that this work done on the electric dipole will be stored as electrical potential energy in it. Therefore, so that sentence you have to write. This work done will be stored as electrical potential energy in the dipole. Therefore, what we can write, U is equal to PE into cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. This is the expression for electric potential energy of an electric dipole which is placed in an uniform electric field. Let me repeat once again. See, as the question itself indicates, you have to imagine a region containing uniform electric field. So I have got a set of parallel lines from left to right. That is, the direction of electric field is from negative to positive x-axis. In the presence of that electric field, I have kept one electric dipole containing two equal and opposite charges, minus q and plus q. The direction of electric dipole moment is always from minus charge to plus charge, that is minus q to plus q, that I have shown. Here, theta is the angle made by this electric dipole moment vector with this E vector. Okay, now, so according to our previous derivation, that is expression for torque, we are in a position to answer, so whether the torque acts on this electric dipole or not. Actually, we took the electric field like this there. Okay, no problem, it makes no difference. Okay, here, that's why in order to make you to understand the concept of electric field, I have wrote two plates here. This is positive plate, this is negative plate. No need to show this in the examination. Okay, it is only for understanding purpose. See, the direction of electric field is from positive plate to negative plate. This is uniform electric field. Okay. This positive charge will be strongly attracted by this negative plate. Therefore, the direction of force on this plus q will be in this direction. Similarly, this negative charge is strongly attracted by this positive plate. Hence, the direction of force will be towards the left. These two are the equal and opposite forces acting on this electric dipole simultaneously. Therefore, these two forces form the couple due to which this electric dipole experiences a torque. Isn't it? What is torque? That is force into perpendicular distance multiplied by sine of the angle between. Yes, you know that. See, we know that. The torque acting on the electric dipole is given by tau is equal to PE sine theta. That is the angle between P and E here. Next, the small amount of work done in rotating the dipole from this position to this position, usually we take this is zero potential energy axis. Okay, see, if we lift this electric dipole through some angle theta, then it is nothing but the small amount of work done. It is not small angle, it is just theta. So small angle is represented by d theta. The small work done in rotating the dipole through small angle d theta is given by dw is equal to tau into d theta. How that tau into d theta comes, I have wrote there. Okay, next. The value of tau from equation 1 I have extracted and substituted here. Therefore, it is dw is equal to PE sin theta d theta. Next, this is just a small work done. What is the total work done in rotating that dipole from some angular position theta 1 to theta 2? For example, if you call this as theta 1, next, this as theta 2. What is the total work done means? It is obtained by integrating dw. Therefore, w is equal to integral theta 1 to theta 2 of dw. The remaining thing is mathematical steps. Here, integration of sin theta is cos theta, minus cos theta. I have taken that negative sign outside. So, next remaining thing up to here, the mathematical steps here. This work done on this electric dipole will be stored as electrical potential energy in it. Therefore, in place of W, we usually write U. U is equal to PE into cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. This is the actual expression for electric potential energy of an electric dipole. Okay, now let us discuss few special cases. See that for that final expression, I will call equation number 2. For my reference, I will call this as equation number 2. Okay, from equation 2. From equation 2, if theta 1 is equal to 90 degree and theta 2 is equal to 0 degree, if we select the conditions like this, initially the electric dipole was like this, it seems, that is theta 1, which is 90 degree. Now somebody has rotated it through angle theta 2, I will call this as just theta first. Okay, so somebody has turned it through some angle, therefore it makes new angle theta. Under this condition, that equation number 2 will become U is equal to minus PE cos theta. Correct? See, cos theta 1, theta 1 is equal to 90 degree, cos 90 is 0. Next, theta 2 is equal to just theta, therefore minus cos theta. U is equal to minus PE cos theta will come. Okay, now if here theta is equal to 0 degree, very very important cases, please remember, if theta is equal to 0 degree, U will become minus PE, and we call this condition as minimum potential energy condition. Minimum potential energy condition. Under such condition, the dipole is said to be under stable equilibrium. What? Stable equilibrium. Dipole will be at stable equilibrium. Why we call it as a stable equilibrium means theta is equal to 0. Just take a look here. Electric field is like this. This is the negative plate. This is the positive plate. I have pressed the dipole like this now. That is minus Q plus Q. The direction of dipole moment is also along the direction of electric field. Right now the theta value becomes 0. Now this positive charge is strongly attracted by negative. This negative charge is strongly attracted by this positive plate. Therefore, it remains fixed in that position firmly. Okay. Hence, it is said to be a stable equilibrium condition. It is just like, so this is the north pole and here is the south pole, for example. When you place like this, they get attracted towards each other. Under such condition, nobody can able to separate it, isn't it? So therefore, that type of condition here, dipole moment and this electric field direction, both are same, therefore theta is equal to 0. Under such condition, positive charge is strongly bounded to this negative, and negative charge is strongly bounded to this positive plate. Hence, we say that, what? Stable equilibrium condition, okay? Next, similarly, when theta is equal to 180 degree, what you get? 180 degree means the direction of electric dipole moment and the direction of electric field are opposite. If theta is equal to 180 degree, from that equation 2, what happens? U will become minus P into cos 180. What is cos 180? Cos 180 is minus 1. Hence, cos 180 is minus 1. Hence, it will become U is equal to minus 1 into minus PE, which is plus PE. U becomes plus PE. This condition is called maximum potential energy condition. This is maximum potential energy condition. And under such condition, the dipole will be in unstable equilibrium. Why we can call this as unstable equilibrium means? Please remember, again I will take the same example. Okay, this is the direction of electric field. But here, the dipole has to be placed like this. Minus Q, plus Q. Therefore, dipole axis. This is dipole axis and this is dipole moment. Direction of dipole moment is opposite to the direction of electric field. Under such condition, it is a case where you forcefully drive the north pole towards the north pole. As long as you hold it, it remains. As soon as you leave it, it will turn like this. Therefore, its condition is unstable because it is in a tendency to move like this, because this is positive charge which is strongly repelled by this positive plate. Okay, therefore it has to be, it tends to turn like this. Therefore, its condition is unstable. And similarly, the last special case, when theta is equal to 90 degree, what happens to the potential energy? From that equation you can say, so that is minus PE cos 90. What is the value of cos 90? It is 0. Therefore, simply the electric dipole possesses no potential energy when it is held like this. Under such condition, the potential energy of an electric dipole will be 0. Okay. So, in the same way, the amount of work done in bringing this dipole from infinity to uniform electric field, perpendicular to the direction or normal to the direction of this electric field, is 0. Please remember, it is not for theory, it is for your objectives. The amount of work done in bringing an electric dipole from infinity to an external electric field, which is uniform external electric field, normal to the direction of electric field, is 0. It is just like this. The potential energy will be 0. Okay. Anyhow, thanks for watching.